Hello and welcome to Let's Play Destroy All Humans 2 with me, Mr. Muckluckable. In the last episode, we helped Natalia reach her secret agent informant known as Sergei, who we're very jealous of because that beautiful Natalia seems a bit closer to him than she does to us. Go away, I'm trying to explain what happened. Ooh, there's another one. Come on, man. Right. So, in today's episode, let's see, there's a cult mission we could do, but instead we're going to go to Parliament because it's time for the boss of Albion. It's a good un. I like this boss. So, I shall cut forward to when we are in Parliament. Oh, god damn, how do we get that Furotech cell? This is going to be tricky. Come on now, we can do this.
Don't ever do that again.
Get on the... Why do I fail? Yes. And up again, yeah, there we go. What are we up to now? 5, oh, yeah, that's right. Carrying on. Okay, it was actually just around the corner, but I decided to cut anyway because I had a cough. And you don't want to hear me coughing. So, who's it going to be? Oh, it's Ponsonby. Hello.
Morning, Ponsonby. You rang?
Yeah. Why are you acting so weird, Ponsonby? What is up?
This better be good. I was this close to second base with Princess Margaret.
Oh my.
I appreciate your coming on such short notice, sir. This is of the greatest importance.
Ask cynical question.
Important to who? Me or you?
To both of us, I think. We should whisper in case of surveillance. It concerns...
Oh, okay. This is serious.
What was so sleepy? You,
Lower life forms, when will they ever learn?
My head feels like Tiny Tim just whacked me with a ukulele. What happened?
Oh, good, you're back with us again. I trust you're comfortably tipsy. How do you feel?
Well, what the hell's going on? Yeah, it turns out Ponsonby isn't the nice English-British gentleman he seems to be. My goodness, no. Yeah, they're always the ones to turn out to be evil, aren't they? Okay. We've got a series of questions and responses and all that stuff now. I don't think it really matters which ones you pick, but they're quite funny, some of them. Act nonchalant, yes.
I could use a martini. After a hard day getting drugged and kidnapped, nothing else really hits the spot. Know what I'm saying?
Perhaps we should try another 4 cc's of Demerol, Switch second.
Oh,
to level
more
3
drugs.
And prepare the encephalogram.
Don't do drugs, kids.
Now, I want you to tell me all the good things you remember about your mother.
Oh, humor him.
Mommy. No, mommy. Not the hot iron again. I'll be good. I promise.
Subject. Fighting the effects of the theorem.
Perhaps another approach
is more effective.
More drugs. I hate you, Ponsonby.
The Boffins have been examining your weapon's power sources, Cryptosporidium. We're all quite curious as to how the stored MU phase pulse is channeled in the first place.
Oh, display violent temper. That's what we're good at.
Keep it up, Ponsonby. That barrier can't stand up against my psychokinesis forever. And when it goes, oh, pow, to the moon, Ponzi!
Clearly deranged. Phenobarbital will put an end to that mischief.
Oh, see, this has gone for a while, but it's because it's so evil. He wants us for information.
We know you have it. Tell us where it is. Tell us, or it's the Ludovico treatment for you.
That is from Clockwork Orange. With Eno. The eyes peeled back, watching horrible scenes of violence. Revert to childhood.
Uncle Orthopox,
no, they showed us Clockwork Orange in year.
Ooh.
Year 12, so we were.
About
16, 17. Clockwork Orange was a film that was banned for about 25 years because of its violence. That's weird, isn't it? Don't you think that's a bit weird? I don't know.
Attention. Security breach in access facility. Codes Cromarty, Dogger, and Finisterre are in force. Repeat.
What was all that about? Oh, my freaking head. This gas is noxious. Smells like Pox's underwear. Don't ask me how I know that. Hey, what the? Damn dirty apes! Where the hell am I?
You're in the Abscess Mental Reconditioning Facility, under the streets of Albion. Looks like I got here just in time. Now come on, spaceman. Move your ass!
I don't get it. Why are you helping me?
Because I know now. You're the only one I can trust. Anyway, who else is going to rescue you?
Oh, Natalia. You're my hero.
If you can hear me, meet me in the park. It seems that treacherous humans damaged some of your equipment.
Some, it's damaged all of it, practically.
To your new package.
Yeah. Crap. Oh, we have a new ability now. Mind Flash. Ponsonby's brainwashing chemicals have unlocked her latent Furon ability. Mind Flash. Mind Flash completely stuns every human in the world for a period of time. To trigger a Mind Flash, hold the circle button. Mind Flash is recharged by consuming human brains, which you get from using the anal probe. So that's why the anal probe is good. It all makes sense now. I've got no... Oh, crap. If nothing works, then how am I supposed to get rid of you? I don't do that. Right. So basically, none of your weapons work. You're trapped down in the sewers or the underground. And you have to figure out a way to escape. I think the tactic I'm going to go for on this guy anyway is can we body snatch you? Oh god, there's another one. Forget. Okay. Now let's just run away. God, when I didn't have any upgrades and I died so many times in this bit. I don't know why. My brain did not work and I couldn't figure out what to do. Goodbye, gentlemen. See, with body snatching this part, it's actually quite easy because they're kind of like, oh, where is he? We do have some mines up here which you can PK. And why not PK them into the people in front of you? Make use of the explosives. Oh crap, I didn't do that. Oh well, run away! Run away. There's lots of people up here that would kill you if you were in alien form, but I'm not, and I'm going the wrong way. So overall, that does get rather easy. I should have done that the first time. Let's pick up this Furotex cell here. Thank you. 6. I don't want to escape from my human form just yet, because they may still be able to see me. Let's get around here first. Okay. Oh god, are they secret agents or KGB? They are secret agents, and I need you for my gene blending. Oh crap, my disguise is running out. Run away! Yeah, we have to go see Pox. to go find Pox. That bit was actually very, very easy and went rather smoothly. I am pleased. Where are you, Pox?
Pox, man, I have never been so glad to see you. Actually, I've never been glad to see you, but
oh, don't be like that, Crypto.
Serves you right for trusting a human. What in the musky name of our foodle happened down there?
Oh, okay. Let's brag about our clever escape, because it was rather clever.
Well, I ran into a little static with Ponsonby. Nothing major. Little wham-bam, thank you, ma'am, and he was history, and I was
wham-bam. Thank you, ma'am.
Is that so? Then why didn't I hear you shooting back at him?
Confess ignorance.
Okay, look. Something's wrong with the guns. They're all screwed up.
Alright, so our guns are screwed up, yes. Thank you, Pox. Pox can repair them for us using his little holopod.
I expected I'd find you here. You're quite sporting, Crypto, and I do admire your spirit. But at some point, one simply has to face the fact that the other man's won. Of course, you couldn't know who you were up against, M16, or perhaps I should say, Majestic Command, 16th Sector. By the way, I have you surrounded. Take off now, and my surface-to-air launchers will destroy you and your precious saucer. The only way you'll leave here alive is in my custody. Come now, there's no need for any unpleasantness. It's undignified. It's beneath us. You've lost fair and square. Now be a man and show a little sportsmanship. There's a good fellow.
Oh, God, get the hell out of there quickly. There is a lot of things there ready to kill us. And, yeah, he is definitely evil. If you weren't sure before, now you can be sure. He is evil. Pure evil. He's from Majestic Command, whatever that is. I think that may be from the previous game. I don't know. I haven't played the first game. Oh, anyway. So this is the boss. There's his health bar up there, Ponsonby. Now, there are a couple of ways to do this. The way I did it first time is I stuck to the ground and... Where is he? I can vaguely see the pink marker. I stuck to the ground and I stayed at a distance far away enough that he couldn't shoot me, but I could shoot him. And it took a while, I admit. But I was just kind of over here-ish. No, actually, I was more towards the middle. And I was just firing away my Zap-O-Matic and my disintegrator ray. And it got the job done, albeit very slowly. He shoots you with the umbrella gun. Where are you going? There you are. But it doesn't do much damage, you see. If at all. Where are you? There you are. So you can zap, and he moves about. That's the problem. He moves about. He's actually in a better position when I did it before. Not so close to the other things. But there you go, look. His health finally went down. There you are, chasing him now. But he doesn't go past a certain point. So if you can stay here. Oh no, he's still shooting. About here? No, it's still shooting. Here. Okay. So when the health bar comes up, means you can. Oh, killing him. So what, have we got... Screw it, let's do a little bit of a meteor strike on his head. And this is where you find out that Ponsonby is superhuman. He just took a meteor to the head! Well, you know, good for him. Now, the other way to do it, and I'll show that anyway, because I might as well. Which is probably the better method. It does take a bit of wiggling about from missiles, but yes. You go in the saucer, because your detonator is going to do a lot more damage than your puny little weapons. So if we just call it in quickly. The problem is you have a lot of, as he said, surface-to-air missiles. SAM sites. And that can pose a problem, especially when our saucer health is so low. I really should have upgraded that. Okay, if we can actually see where he is. Oh, God, it's happening already.
No human craft can maneuver like that.
Alright. Get rid of some of these. Get rid of some of these around here. you go. Where are you, Ponsonby? There. And fry him. Look how quickly it goes down there. Oh, crap. Oh, crap. Wiggle. Wiggle. I'm just going to fire blindly through the tree and hopefully get him. There we go.
You bastard. You finally did it. M16 was all there was left. The last of the Majestic agencies. All the others. The French. The Mongolian station. The Argentinians. Every one of them. Destroyed by... aliens.
That last round must have scrambled your synapses. I only took down the American Majestic. Silhouettes Majestic.
You? You cosmic egomaniac. You think this is all about you? Oh, the irony. Beaten by a solipsistic simpleton from space. You actually believe you're the only...
The only... What?
Leave it alone, Crypto. The man was in the throes of a violent demise and clearly not in his right mind. Now, you've had your fun. Can we please just go?
Well, there we are. That was a dramatic death scene, if I've ever seen one before. But now he's gone. Ponsonby's gone, and he did, let loose quite a bit of information there before he died. The bit about the American Majestic, I do think is from the previous game. But all that stuff about not being the only dead. I don't think I'm going to spoil it, but because it's pretty obvious what he's going to say. But yes, it seems we may not be the only aliens in this game. Sorry for the annoying cut, just dogs being annoying. Okay, so that's probably going to be enough for this episode. We have a lot to do now. We have another story mission, we have a side mission, we still have that cult mission to do. Let's just quickly have a look at how we're doing. That is the last story mission, that one flashing up right now. We still have a lot of cult mission to do. That is probably what we're going to need to do next episode. Our job's still got a few to do. Data core's done. Furotech cells, yeah. Artifacts, yeah. Landing zones, done. And gene blends, yeah. We're getting there, slowly but surely. So, until next episode, where we'll probably do some cult missions, goodbye. We'll be right back.